Using two components and a simple script, the agent can go from point A to point B. Today we're going to look at what Unity's AI navigation can do. The navigation doesn't just work in a straight line, it'll navigate around objects dynamically. Pretty cool. NavMesh surfaces can be baked onto almost anything. You can do bridges, you can do stairs, you can even do disconnected meshes if you use a NavMesh link. Look, the agent will jump between point A and point B. Yes, Unity's NavMesh system is pretty cool. Let's take a look at how to set it up. Let's create an empty game object to attach the NavMesh surface component. This component doesn't need to be on any geometry. Next, we'll select the agent and add the NavMesh agent component. This allows the character to walk around. Now we just rebake the NavMesh surface. We just need to tell the agent where to go. Let's select the agent, add a new script called GoToObject, and we'll go ahead and edit that. First, we'll get a reference to the NavMesh agent component so we can set the destination. Now we'll make a public game object to set the target, and then we'll go ahead and set the destination on our agent. If we set the component reference and hit play, we can see the agent walk to the goal. Now that was really easy for three lines of code. Let's make our agent more dynamic. If we update the destination more often, like in the update loop, the agent will now chase something. Using a basic spline animate component, our agent can now chase an object around a track. Cool. Let's take this a step further by having the agents hide from each other in a maze. We'll use the nav mesh to do the heavy lifting and write a simple AI script to move the agents and check when they're hidden. Let's create a few class variables to keep track of our states. We'll also just use a few constants here and there to make the thing tunable. I like to keep the variables private until they've reached a good tuning point, and then I'll change them to serializable or public. This approach works a little bit better for me instead of making a scriptable object or having to tune dozens and dozens of game objects. We're making a coroutine to find the hiding spot. It'll keep searching until it's reached a maximum amount of attempts, or until a hiding spot is found. We need to know when to stop, so we'll go ahead and use the remaining distance on the agent to the goal to know when to stop the agent. Each agent has a component on it called hideable. We'll search for that component, and then we'll do a raycast to see if we're able to see any of those or if we're just hitting walls. To find a hiding spot within the navigation mesh, we can use the vertices that make up the triangles that make up the mesh, and then we can pick a random triangle and we can get a random point within that triangle to go hide to. This is a great way to get a point within a mesh like the nav mesh without having to do something like a guess and check. This really basic script will help the agent find a spot, it'll navigate to that spot, and it'll check to see if it's hidden. Let's watch these guys try to hide for a bit. Our AI agents now pick a point on the maze, navigate to that point, and then check to see if they're within any kind of other AI's sight. Just a few more left trying to find an empty spot, and there we go. The agent's destination isn't the only thing we can update. We can also update the nav mesh itself. Check out this problem, that nav mesh isn't actually updating. Let's fix it. We'll make a basic coroutine that runs once every 15th of a second, and we'll update the nav mesh as we go. Our agent acts like normal and just waits for a path to become available, then he'll just go ahead and cross that bridge. We could apply this technique with many meshes, but keep in mind that there's a performance hit as the AI agent will attempt to calculate a new path every time the mesh updates. I hope you found this useful, and let me know what you want to see next in the comments.